Lark?
Cecile?
What have you been up to? You haven't been back home in forever. Everyone's worried about you.
Sorry, there's been so much going on since I left.
We can talk later. For now, let's go back to Zanuel's.
Is he really doing that bad?
The doctor just said to prepare yourself, that's all. Anyway, you need to see him. He's been worried about you guys.
His internal organs have already begun to crystallize. There's really nothing we can do for him now.
Oh, no.
It's a miracle he's breathing right now, to be honest. If you'll excuse me, then.
Lark!
Mom, what's going on?
The doctor couldn't do anything for Zamuel?
No, he couldn't stop the process. Nobody can. Nobody knows why it's happening to him.
I can't believe it!
Lark? Is that you?
Grandpa!
Where's Adele?
She was kidnapped by the Alkinians in Antrax.
Oh, so she took on her role as D.Va in the end.
What do you mean?
Wait, Lark! Zamuel's in a lot of pain. Don't make him talk if he doesn't.
It's fine, Ifya. I'm going to die soon. Anyway, I have to tell him the truth before I pass on. It's been 15 years since that day. The D.Va of Alkinism at the time was being targeted by a man named Ignacy. To keep her daughter from harm's way, she asked us, the Lord Knights, to take her into custody.
The contract stated that Adele would take over as D.Va if something happened to her mother.
You knew about all this?
Yes, so did your father, rest his soul, and Leon too. We kept it a secret to protect Adele from whatever danger she was in.
I feel as if a great weight has been lifted from my shoulders. If we couldn't fulfill our contract, it would have ruined the Lord Knight's name.
Grandpa!
Samuel!
Looks like Rex has finally come for me.
Grandpa, don't leave us!
Lark, tell Leon I'll be celebrating our success on the other side. Just a little earlier than you.
Grandpa! Zamuel! Master! Oh, Rifia. Sorry to drag you into helping with Grandpa's funeral. What are you...
Anytime I was sad or hurt, my mother would always hug me like this. Lark.
Hey, Lark. I need to ask you something. Huh?
Wait, it's not what you think.
Oh, excuse me. I didn't mean to interrupt. Please do continue.
Cecile sure is acting strange. Good morning, Lark.
Mom, are you sure it's okay for you to be on your feet?
Oh, I'm fine. Since Zamuel passed, I have a lot more things I have to do around here.
Oh, you done now, ladies' man?
What did you need to talk to me about?
Oh, I heard from Nico that you guys were going to Carbunculus after this.
Is
that true?
Yeah, it's our last mission. When I'm done with it, I'll be free of the Imperial Army for good.
That sounds great! Take me with you!
Why would I do that?
I want to get revenge for Zamuel!
What do you mean, revenge? Wait, you mean Ignacy is in Carbunculus?
According to Leon, I mean Rastan, yes!
Why are you talking about Rastan all of a sudden?
Because he's the one that said Ignacy's base is in Carbunculus. We thought he had captured you guys or something. Rastan is already heading for Carbunculus now.
Leon is going to Carbunculus? Well, we can't just sit here. I need to go as soon as I can.
Me too. I want to go too. Please. Come on, take me too.
I can't. You're a civilian. This is a military operation.
But what about Rithia?
We're taking her because she was born in Tremilia. I'm going to be dropping her off there once the mission's over.
That's not fair!
Lark, let's take Cecile with us.
We aren't going out on a field trip, you know.
You're only taking Rithia because you think she's cute.
Who? Me?
Well, fine. See if I care. I'll get revenge for Gramps all by myself.
Are you sure you should let that little girl go off by herself like that, Lark?
Ah, just let her go. What about Nico, though? Where's he?
Someone from the military needed to see him. He's talking to them outside. I think it was General Freya.
Probably haggling over the mission pay, no doubt.
Mr. Lark, what's going on? Cecile just came by yelling, "Lark's nothing but a big pervert!"
Yeah, spoiled brat.
First Sergeant Lagoon, I have word about your reward for the Antrax mission from Prince Vice.
Yeah? The deal said he'd pay as much as I needed.
The Emperor stated that he would provide enough to guarantee Elena a comfortable existence. In addition to medical costs, he has agreed to pay you 100,000 Rico a month in financial aid.
You're serious?
Oh yes. He thought you would be most satisfied with that.
I can't take that much money.
Mom.
You do not have the right to refuse it. This agreement has been forged between the Prince and First Sergeant Lagoon.
Just take it, Mom. This way, I can run my next mission without worrying about you.
Lark.
If you're satisfied with this, First Sergeant Lagoon, I will take my leave. I'll handle all the paperwork here. Have a pleasant trip to Carbunculus.
Thank you.
If you become a mercenary, we may just be enemies the next time we meet.
What were you talking about with General Freya, Nico?
I asked for permission to resign, of course.
Oh yeah. I remember you saying something about that.
Lark.
Well, you heard him. Guess you don't have to worry about making ends meet anymore. Anyway, I have to go now. I have a job to do. Take care of everything around here, okay?
Never mind. Just be careful.
Elena, it was a pleasure.
The pleasure was all mine. Have a safe trip back to the Republic.
Okay, you two, let's get out of here.